It's an eclectic group of people out here that live in Coney Island.
Right. Still on, then we're going.
You couldn't build this on a Hollywood set, so I understand why they used it for the movie to begin with, and why Eric wanted to use it again. My character goes through the movie trying to save souls.
You gotta remember, folks, you know, my name is Dorsey Wright, not Cleon.
So when he called me, it was like, I don't think I want to do it. I then met with him, and he's very persistent. And I looked over some of the things that he had already shot. And then he told me that he was also talking to Brian Tyler, who plays Snow. Me and Brian go way back, almost even before the war. We lived in the same building while we were shooting the war. And me and Brian talked and we said, okay, this guy seems enterprising. I mean, he's not a jerk. He actually knows what he wants to do. And anybody who puts that much effort into doing something, I'm all for it.
So we came out to do the movie for Eric Rivas, Vamp Bikers. Me and Brian Tyler from the Warriors, definitely got to see him. And had a pretty good time.
My experience on the film as a whole, should I say, it's been amazing. I can't even count how many times we've had an awesome time back and forth. When it's time to get things done, we get things done. We run into some snafus sometimes, but at the end of the day, where there's a will, there's a way. There's always a way with the Vamp Bikers crew, you heard? Everywhere you look, from every angle, you've had some very talented people stepping up to the plate and doing what they gotta do, and surprising everybody every time. So overall, I want to say it's been a pleasure. I thank Eric for letting me be part of it. I know we're gonna take it a whole lot farther. This ain't the end, this ain't the beginning. One of my favorite scenes, I would say, would be the wolf scene. The wolf scene was an awesome scene. We got with Mike Wolfpack Brennan. Mike was, he was awesome. He was awesome.
We didn't lose your daughter, man!
Another scene that was pretty awesome, that we put in a lot of work. It took a big team effort, and that was the hospital scene when we broke Lilo out of the hospital. That was an awesome scene. We put a lot of energy into it. It shows. It was pretty awesome. It goes, like they say, 0 to 100 real quick. Eric, he's a wizard.
Well, who doesn't like acting as a witch? You have superpowers, you get to be powerful, you can kick people's asses, and you get to fly. Working with Eric is an experience of its own, I would say. He's very impulsive and he's very creative, and you never know what happens when you come to set. But I love it because it's a lot of fun. So it's he manages to really bring the joy into what you're creating, and you feel like you're a part of something, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, it was exciting, I would say. It was a little chaotic. I like to say it's guerrilla filmmaking, because we just march into places and locations and go for it. So the whole filming of the movie is actually an experience in itself. He also approaches everything like a team, so he gets people involved, he asks them for their opinion, and if you have an idea, you can bring it to him and he will include it if he likes it. So there's a constant flying of ideas going back and forth. But I learned a lot. I learned a lot about filmmaking. I learned a lot about the technical aspects of it. And in the end, you get to see yourself on screen.
The first time I went
and met Eric filming something, it was out in Coney Island. I actually had never been to Coney Island. And right away, it was fun. I think I just, I don't care about hierarchies and all the big fuss that people make about this whole filmmaking. What I care about is if you get a good product in the end or not. And so I was intrigued meeting him. And he's a very likable guy, so we all had some beers afterwards and it was fun. So when he asked me the next time, yeah, I went back. I think because he gets carried away and then you have to sort of bring him back down to earth. Because what's still important at the end of the day is that you have some sort of consistency and there's a story being told that people can follow. But the wonderful thing about him is that he actually listens and he's open to ideas and suggestions. And he's juggling a lot of different personalities and the different egos and different, everybody comes to him with their own needs. So it's not easy, I think.
Amanda Jensik, I'm a Brooklyn-based actress, filmmaker, and makeup artist. I'm grateful for this opportunity to work with this diverse cast of characters. It was refreshing. It was so, so refreshing to work with a female cinematographer and a strong cast of women in a very male-dominated business and environment. Well, that's an environment that's usually very male-dominated. So that was extremely refreshing for me. And director Eric Rivas really pushed me to the next level emotionally, and he allowed me a lot of creative freedom, which was very interesting. I'm looking forward to working on more feature films and future collaborations with Diamond Mines.
Well, first of all, you would expect with a name like Screamin' Rachel, horror is my genre. And I started my horror career out in a film called Night Owl with John Leguizamo. You know John, so it's pretty cool, it's very, very underground. But then again, we are underground, but with a lot of edge. It has been great working with Eric. I think he's got fantastic vision and his cinematography is amazing. And of course, I wouldn't know who Eric was or about Eric if it wasn't for my mentor, Apache Ramos, the man who first discovered me and brought me to New York. Well, since that time, I've been doing lots of great stuff, notably the First Lady of House Music and Trax Records. So another good thing about my experience with Vamp Bikers is the fact that Trax Records is doing the soundtrack. And another thing is I was able to bring in two of my good friends, Michael Musto, who I actually met years and years ago, and we won't even say when, on the streets of New York. And also, well, you know, my kind of frenemy, because I love him, but I don't know what to think about him, and that's Michael Alec. And all the other great people, Angel Salazar, Lilo Bacanti. But, you know, Eric is one of those great directors who kind of just lets you be yourself, and that's amazing. I mean, you know, so he brings out the best of us. He's always putting me in these kind of tough, broad situations, as well as, you know, I got to beat the hell out of Michael Alec, and that was really fun. We did some great shooting at Coney Island, you know, there was some really, you know, things that we did like uptown, you know, with Apache and just getting turned into a vampire. Well, that was one of my favorite scenes of all. I think it's going to be a lot more than just a cult classic. I think it is a classic for all people, and I think that you couldn't have anything cooler than zombies, bikers, who knows, maybe it'll be up-and-coming werewolves. I don't know, but you might say I'm a witch, but I'm really a vampire. Coming to get you. Vamp Bikers in the house.
I had an amazing time working on Vamp Bikers. It was so much fun. I met so many wonderful, talented, dedicated people. Everyone was so in sync all the time. There were a few times we were on set and it was 17 degrees out, 20 degrees out, so cold. No one complained. The scene needed to get done, and that was it. Our camera girl, Martina Meal, frozen fingers and all, she got the scene and never complained. She's awesome. Creating the zombies was cool. I got to work with my friend Dina, who I know for over 25 years, Dina Rosato. We did the makeup together. Also with Amanda Jensik, who's very sweet. We met her on set, and she's also very talented. We worked really good together. We had an amazing time. And my friend, Eric Rivas, who I know for over 30 years, he was so determined and dedicated. No one was there as much as him. I think he found a great bunch of actors. No, I know he found a great bunch of actors.
It was a blast.
There were so many interesting people.
My name is Jerry fucking Visco. Geraldine Visco, and guess what? I was in Vampiker's Tress, directed by Eric Rivas, because it was fun. And it's a fabulous film, it really is. But also, I really did enjoy being in it because of the people in it. The actors and the cast were really fascinating and fun. And so I met a lot of interesting people. Okay, like I knew Michael Alec, he's a friend of mine. And then, you know, Karen Frangala-Smith, I had her come into the film and I really adore her. Lilo Brancato, yes, Lilo Brancato, Angelo Salazar, there's really fabulous and fun people in the film. And I adored being in it. So, yes, I do recommend working with director Eric Rivas because it was fun, it was interesting. And also, I was able to play different types of characters. Of course, I was known as a bruja, which is a witch, but I would say that I'm actually a goddess and a saint. My friend, Ron Jeremy, I brought him in because I was doing the New York City Porn Festival last summer in Brooklyn, and so I was able to get Ron Jeremy to fly in here from Los Angeles. And so I had the Vampikers people, some of them came to the porn festival, and because I was actually in one of the porn films that Ron Jeremy was on my panel. And so I said to Ron, I was like, hey, can you be in the Vampikers film? And of course he's always looking for money, but we were able to persuade him to do it because he was getting paid for doing the panel at the porn festival, but he was fabulous and he's a great actor and he's famous and funny and I love him. So anyway, it was great to have Ron Jeremy in there. And yes, we did have some really interesting characters in there. The funny thing also is a lot of the actors in the film were actually people who have been in criminal things, but yeah, what are you gonna do? The world is like that, so what? That's what I like about Eric Rivas, the director. He actually is interested in controversial characters, which is cool. Unlike some film directors, some casting agents really are a turnoff, you know. But yeah, I tend to like the directors more because they're more experimental. So yes, there was a lot of fun stuff about it. And I learned a lot about zombies and vampires and brujas. Yeah, so I recommend it. Yes, I do.
Hi, I'm Ron Jeremy. And you really should watch Vampiker's Tress. It's gonna be a killer film.
Okay, it was the summer of 2012 when I was on Facebook and I saw this thing called Lost in Coney Island, a kind of a parody of The Warriors. And I really liked it. I saw something there that I liked. So I got in touch with, via Facebook, Eric Spade Rivas and Ronnie Rebel, the boy, and Anne Marie, and I was invited down. This orphan was invited down to Coney Island to meet the Lost in Coney Island, and I met this bunch of creative people that just blew my mind. And the next thing I know, I was adopted by the Diamond Mines crew, and I was told about this project, Vampikers. You could use in real vamp. Bikers in New York City, and the next thing I know, I had a part, and I even got a t-shirt, Vampikers, and I play Sergeant Snow, and I got to work with all these creative people, and I became part of the family, and the next thing you know, Lost in Coney Island won Best Picture on 8/20/2012 at the Coney Island Film Festival. And here I am hanging out with this crew. I love the creativeness, working with the different biker crews, the vampires. I mean, how only Eric Spade Rivas could put these people together. I just want you all guys to come and see it. These are really young, creative actors. They got a lot of actors here that have done a lot of things. There's a lot of, I called the director Eric Spade Rivas the ringmaster, because he put this crew together of all kinds of people. I don't want to mention names because I'm going to like miss somebody.
My name is Manny. I'm part of the Vamp Bikers movement. I'm one of the actors. Great times on set. Everett Rivas, great guy, great director. He brings out the best in all of his actors. I've been working with Mr. Rivas for now, you could say over 6 years. Helped me with my acting skills. Part of his Diamond Mine crew, the Diamond Mine legacy. Fun times, I tell you. So many, I can't even remember one. I'd like to give a shout to all the actors that were in the film. Hopefully, you know, we could see better things for the success of the film crew and the actors. This is 2017, Brooklyn. We filmed at Coney Island, the best times. I'm originally from Marlboro Projects. Shout outs to everybody in Marlboro. Shout outs to everybody in Borough Park, Bay Ridge, Brooklyn, Flatbush. I hope you guys see Vamp Bikers Stress. I'm in the film.
Yeah, get him some coffee too. I can't.
It will be over for
the All right, Ray Liotta.
I got involved with Vamp Bikers through Jerry Visco. Jerry's one of those people who, when she met me probably almost 10 years ago, she always thought I should do acting. And having had an acting background herself, I definitely felt she, you know, was biased, and because she is so eccentric and, you know, batshit. I took it with a grain of salt, but she really pushed for me to be involved with Vamp Bikers, and I'm pretty sure she, like, harassed Eric to cast me for, I think I was supposed to just have like a cameo, so I was like, yeah, whatever, I'll go to Coney Island. Funny enough, when I actually went on set to Coney, we never ended up using that footage, but it ended up becoming more than just a film. It kind of became like improv theater, you know, or improv comedy in a lot of ways, because with a group of people who aren't traditional actors or actors for that fact, there was a lot of creativity and just kind of basing a lot of the scenes off of everyone's strengths and personalities. I think Michael Musto was another person who really kind of kept me interested in the film, because Michael's one of the first people I met in nightlife when I started going out. And I always thought that anything that Michael's involved with just had to be super cool. So it's been a lot of fun. Eric is such a great director in the sense that, you know, he's just like any other person on set. He doesn't really play the director role as far as like the pretense and the aura. He's very down to earth and he has a nurturing sense to him. You can tell he's a father. And as any father myself, I now appreciate that even more. I think definitely the film is unique because it's not about kind of trying to cater to what's popular. It's about creativity, and you know, a lot of times when you have big money, you have big people to answer to. And the awesome thing about this project is there's been a lot of freedom. I'm very authentic, and that's definitely rare these days, even in creative scenes, believe it or not. You know, that's definitely been, I think, an added bonus for me. And yeah, definitely, you know, other than bed bugs I've gotten from this project, which I'm joking, I have gotten the acting bug, and I would like to do more things, definitely more things with Eric. And I think at the end of the day, if you can find a project where you can relate and feel like it's an extension of who you are, that was more acceptable. I think that's been a recurring theme in my personal life. So this has been cool because it's like, hey, you're a freak, we know that, and we want to embrace that and embody that in what you're doing. So it's been a lot of fun. I want to thank you know, Eric and Martine and all the people who have really put their time, because, you know, this wasn't a money project, and I think it was a passion project, and you definitely can feel that. If anyone can say anything, you can't say there wasn't any passion in Vamp Bikers.
I went on a trip and was visiting Jerry Visco, who's also in the movie, watched the entire rough footage screening, and afterwards, Eric Rivas, director, approached me and asked me if I would be interested in being in the movie. So I said, sure. I mean, the cast of people in it, the cast of characters are amazing. I mean, you have Michael Alec, you have Lilo Brancato, Jerry Visco, and Michael Musto, and Ron Jeremy, whom I've known forever. So I end up the next day driving all the way out to Coney Island for the shoot. The makeup artists were fabulous. They had me done up as a zombie like you wouldn't believe. And I got choked, pushed up against a wall, I got roughed up. I mean, it was a lot of fun though, but the choking was almost real. The guy like grabbed me and pushed me up, and really, I couldn't even breathe. I flew back to LA, and I get another call, and Eric wants me to come back in. So I come back in, and this time it's another zombie fighting scene. I'm like, oh my God, I'm gonna get beat up again or something, right? So I get to Coney Island, and Eric, who likes to do things guerrilla style, and in the nighttime, of course, but he, had a little problem because we couldn't shoot on the beach, so we had to go find somewhere else. So we end up going to Seagate. I swear, somebody could have been murdered there, and you would never find them again. Going, oh my God, where am I? All I can see is the Verrazano Bridge in the distance. So we do this fight scene and everything, and choke me, and beat me up, and I hit Kayvon. And I have this line, though. I say, suck my dead dick. Eric came up with this, and I was like, Eric, are you serious? And he's like, dude, it's gonna be great. Trust me, it's gonna be wonderful. So I end up saying it, suck my dead dick, and everybody busted up.
Suck my dead dick, man.
It was at Anthology Films in the Village. I mean, that was off the hook. Everybody was there. Even the Village people showed up. I mean, Lilo Brancato, of course, all the stars, Michael Alec, Michael Musto. And we had a blast. I mean, the movie was phenomenal. And I have to give it to Eric. He's a great director. He's very good at dealing with people. He put together an amazing cast. He's so real. He's so down to earth. He's funny. He can be funny, but he's also very serious. And he knows what he wants. So when you work with him, it's not someone that at one minute he's your friend. Next minute he's your director. The next minute he's laughing up a storm. And Martine is amazing with her photography. And she's so friendly and so down to earth. So Eric, he says in the trailer, Idol walked from LA. I was like, what? I walked from LA? Oh my God. And they even say to me now, I mean, they tell me in LA about this. They go, oh, you're Idol who walked from LA. They think it's so cool. I've been involved in some crazy things in my life, from the O.J. Simpson trial to Jones versus Clinton to one of the craziest interview TV appearances I've ever done with Sacha Baron Cohen on Bruno. But I must say, Eric and his Vamp Bikers trace is way up there. I think you outdid all of them, seriously. I thought I couldn't get any crazier, over the top, or bizarre, and guess what? Vamp Bikers trace, they did it.
Hello, my name is Martine Emil, cinematographer for Vamp Bikers Dos and Tres. First, let me thank Eric for allowing me to be a part of his film. Totally grateful. Thank you very, very much. I can recall my first day. I always say that Vamp Bikers was my introduction into filmmaking. My boot camp, I always say. You know, it was very, very rough. It changed my life. I learned a lot about, you know, the film world and, you know, becoming a cinematographer. And my first day on set, you know, at the Forbidden Ones, you know, I got, you know, yes, you know, a little nervous, happy, you know, I could say I was a lot happy, you know. I was like, wow, I'm finally here. And, you know, one of the first persons I met was Angel Salazar from Scarface. You know, he was telling me some type of joke. I don't know what the joke was. I don't know if it was even funny. sorry, Angel. But he did make me feel comfortable. And one of the first scenes that I shot was, I believe it was a bike scene. You know, I was on a truck. And I had to get a different angle from the main camera. So while we were driving around Williamsburg, you know, doing the scene, I was like, this is amazing. This is so cool. You know, and I was like, yeah, this is amazing. This is so cool. I can't believe it. And also, the scene with Mark and Janelle, we shot that scene in dead winter, February, in Brooklyn, Coney Island, on a crunchy, crunchy, icy sand. And, you know, much respect to those two because they came with it. They came, it was freezing, you know, but we got the scene done. Also, another cool scene, working with Melly Mel. Working with Melly Mel, filming in Grand Central was, you know, another exciting moment. Also working with, Maria. Maria's a fantastic actress. You know, I love looking at, you know, her acting on the screen. And, you know, as time, you know, progressed as far as, filming in Vampikers does, you know, I learned a lot. And, you know, I got comfortable with, you know, all the actors. And when we got a chance to do part three, you know, part tres, you know, a lot of stuff, you know, came to my mind, you know. And, you know, working with Michael Allen, you know, Michael Mutzo, Ido Brancato. Obviously, I can't forget about, you know, Apache Ramos from, you know, he's one of the original, he's one of the members of The Orphans, which was a part of, you know, the other cult classic, Warriors, you know, another movie filmed in Coney Island. Another great actor to work with, you know, made me feel comfortable, you know, as far as, you know, being new to, you know, the film world, you know, makeup artist, you know, part three, you know, we became more of a family, and that's why, you know, I feel so grateful being part of the Vampikers, you know, Dos and Tres family, because, you know, we all came through, we grew, you know. You know, so all I can say is, you know, working on these two films, you know, fantastic, you know, grew as an individual, you know, grew as an artist, and I can't wait, you know, the next series will take me.
Comedian Angel Salazar was supposed to be in it, but he's still in jail for not paying child support.
Making films is a wild ride. I mean, it kind of started because I wanted to act and I couldn't really get roles, but I really had a passion and a drive. I used to watch Marlon Brando, James Dean. I had my favorite actors, Forrest Whitaker, James Spader, Montgomery Clift. I was really into films. One day I had a vacation camera and I had a little movie program in my computer. And I said, let me try and see if I could do something here. And I made a little Chaplin film with Wu-Tang, you know, like if somebody was smoking weed and woke up and saw Charlie Chaplin dancing in front of them, like he came out the TV. And when I realized I could edit that, then I moved on to shoot a feature. You know, as time wore on, I realized that there are many people that are interested in what I'm interested in. So half of the actors would be friends that I grew up with or some people that I met randomly, and another half will be from acting schools where we would cast them. It was the Bikers. I found them easy to work with, and we do, you know, when it comes to stunts and all that, they don't need nobody to come in and you know, fight for them or whatever. You know, everybody, you know, worked hard, and you know, if they throw each other, they throw each other. You know, we really got into it, and you know, I grew up in New York. I'm New Yorican, so I have an affinity with the Latin culture, of course, because I'm Puerto Rican. And you know, we grew up basically the same way. A lot of us guys were in our 40s, so I really got along and became good friends with a lot of the Bikers. And you know, they hold a lot of the values that, you know, core values that the Warriors film actually tries to project in it, when you watch it, the cult classic, which ironically we did bring in Dorsey Wright and Brian Tyler and Apache Ramos from the Warriors. Apache was instrumental in, you know, just really being a big, big, how can you put it, almost like a manager. I mean, he just believed in us and he told everybody about us. And I think it picked up our esteem. You know, one day you're standing there and you're directing, you know, Dorsey Wright and Brian Tyler in a fight scene that they're kind of, you know, Dorsey's creating right in front of you and you're just, you know, setting up camera angles and you're like, wow, I'm shooting the Warriors. And then, you know, you get Lilo Brancato from the Bronx Tale. Now he's working with us and, you know, to impress people like that, you know, in any way with the little equipment that we do have, I would say that we did well.
Michael Ehrlich, who was a friend from the old days on the club scene, who I covered through the ups and the way down, contacted me and he said, Eric Rivas is a filmmaker who wants you to play the part of Hedda Hopper in this third part of a trilogy, Vamp Biker's Tress. And I said, cool, I actually enjoy acting. It takes me outside myself. I thought, finally, I'll get to hang with Michael Ehrlich since his release from prison. I'd been kind of avoiding him. But this was something where I thought we could both focus, and it would help Michael Ehrlich to kind of focus on something creatively, which it did. He pretty much behaved well on the set. There was one blow-up, and there was another time he had a stack of DVDs of murder movies, but I think he was just trying to ruffle my feathers. I enjoyed playing the part because I learned my lines. I'm professional, but I came to the set open to Eric's direction and willing to go in the different ways that the movie kept going, because Eric kept adding new scenes and it became different levels upon levels of reality versus fantasy. And at one point I was playing a hospital, I don't know, a doctor, I guess, with a hypodermic needle. And basically I'm a sadist throughout the whole thing, whether I'm emitting bitchy remarks or just literally torturing and slapping people. And it's fun to play a sadist. I really got off on it. Making the movie was a great experience. We all had a good time. We all bonded on the set. And I think the fun that we had going to the dark side with these characters is infectious. And I think when you watch it, you're really going to enjoy the fact that we had a great time doing this crazy shit. Too sick, twisted shit from the mind of Eric Rivas, and we enjoyed interpreting it, and I really think audiences are going to get a big kick out of it. It's a real cult movie like in the old days. It's a midnight movie, and then when you put it with the other two parts of the trilogy, you have like a real epic, a real midnight epic, but you can watch it any time of the day.
A guy comes up to you in a club and asks you to play God in a club kid zombie movie. I mean, of course I'm going to say yes. What do you think I'm going to say? I've always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I think every night out in Clubland, you know, every night we were on stage at Disco 2000, we were, you know, we were all acting. We were all playing up. You know, I even invited Michael Musto to be part of it. Even Michael Musto was fun to work with. I guess that's a testament to how much fun it was to be on the set of Eric's movie. It was a lot of fun working with Rachel and Ernie and, you know, Keoki and my friend Anne from college. I love acting. I mean, I'd like to keep doing it forever. I'd like it to make it my career. I'm looking for my big breakout part. If there are any directors out there looking for a leading man, here I am.
Hello, everybody. I am Angel Salazar, a.k.a. Chichi from the Movies Cafe. Angel Salazar, famous movie star and successful stand-up comic. Anyway, my experience with the movie that I did with Eric Rivas, director Eric Rivas, Vamp Bikers. It was great, man, working with legends like from the movie The Warriors, Apache Ramos. Apache Ramos was, you know, is in a movie with me, Dorsey Wright, also from the Warriors. Record producer and recording artist Rachel Kane. We had so much fun with this movie, and it's very dark. The plot, very dark, and, you know, but it's got great shots. Eric Rivas did great cinematography. The shots were kind of scary, suspenseful. And we filmed in Coney Island, Brooklyn. And the movies came out really, really good. Also, in the film, I did a scene with a writer from The Village Voice, New York City.
What a better way to die.
Michael Musto, getting Michael Musto, he plays a priest, I play a priest, and he kills me.
Anyway, the point is,
what a better way to die than getting killed by the writer of The Village Voice.
He got three people.
Anyway, the point is, me, Eric Rivas is a genius. Michael, in this movie, a vampire's biker, he got three people that did time in jail.
How better can he kill?
Michael,
three comics.
Michael Lee, and the kid from Brownsville.
It's like a story.
How better can he kill? Three comics in one movie. It's like a story, like a script that somebody wrote. Too good to be true.
What's up, everybody? I enjoyed doing the movie. Thank you to Eric, Lila Brancato, Michael Musto, Michael Alec, and everybody else. Noel Ashman, peace.